Come along with me today on the Etihad A380 once again, but this time in economy. I'm in 47K. That's just about the best seat in the house if you can't be in a premium cabin. Economy space with extra legroom and the best view of that massive A380 wing and engines. We'll also take a little tour of the business and first class cabins, so there's plenty of A380 action upcoming. Welcome to the start of a new little adventure, this time again with Etihad on the A380. But because I did business class on the inaugural when they brought these back into service on the London route, today, just for you and for the amazing engine view from the front of the lower deck, I'm taking economy. I'm in 47K, but we're taking a little quick tour of the upper deck before we go because there's nice light right now, and just show you a little bit of the business in first class, and then we'll head down to economy where I'm gonna be sitting for the next 6 hours. They have three A380s a day by now. When I took the inaugural just a few months ago, it was of course the first one. They had one a day. They're up to three. So a big A380 destination. The only one for Etihad is London. They have one other flight, which is a 787. Did you know that Etihad also has a shower room for first class passengers? Emirates is famous for this, but it's less commonly known that Etihad does it too. Theirs is a smaller space and there's just one, but still, one of very few ways to have a shower in the sky at present. We'll come back to the first class a little later because boarding is starting and I need to get to my seat. Let's sneak in a quick visit to the flight deck.
Please.
Hello.
Oh, hey. Hello.
Gabriel.
Yes. You're very famous.
Oh,
Miguel,
really?
Nice to meet you. Yeah, yeah. How are you doing?
Hey. Hi, how are you?
Sean, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
And now to the forward part of the lower deck, where my economy seat awaits me. And this is the view we booked this for. More of that soon. This is a very full-service feeling economy seat, right down to the thoughtful extra pouches in the seat back. We had a little bit of a delay getting off the gate. About 45 minutes past departure time, maybe close to an hour. For a minute it looked like it was going to be even worse, but the captain said he negotiated the delay down, so good on him for doing that. I met the captain and first officer earlier. They seemed great. They were really interested in what I was doing and loved the A380. That's universal, I found, flying the A380. Everyone that operates it, flies it, works it, loves it, is in awe of it, just like we passengers are. Anyway, getting going now. Probably a 20-25 minute taxi here at busy Heathrow. Lots of ATC restrictions today. The weather has passed that we had earlier this morning, so should be a pretty nice takeoff, I guess. And then 6 and something hours over to Abu Dhabi. Curious to see what the economy service is gonna be like. Already impressed that when we started to get a bit delayed, cabin crew came around with paper cups filled with water for everyone in economy that wanted one. That's just such a nice added touch and one that you wouldn't see at many airlines. They wouldn't bother to do any kind of service until after takeoff, unless delays got exceptionally long. It's such a funny feeling to go from flying US or European carriers and then get on a Gulf carrier like Etihad and feel the difference really in the lounge, but even in economy class here, just such a difference.
The flight time today will be 6 hours and 15 minutes. We're expecting overall a good weather to fly, but we might have a couple of areas of turbulence. So please keep your seatbelt fastened all the time. We'll come back to you before arriving in Abu Dhabi to update the latest arrival time and the weather conditions. from this moment. Relax and enjoy to fly with Etihad Airways. Thank you.
Now time to sit back, relax, and enjoy this glorious A380 takeoff out of London Heathrow. I like how you can keep the moving map and tail camera up side by side on this system. That's the ideal in-flight entertainment setup for me. the sun sets pretty quickly once you get going on this flight. Though the seats may look a little funny with the fixed headrest on one side, it's actually really good for leaning against if you want to get some rest, and you can adjust the other side as needed. I'm a fan of this. Also, the seats in the last row of this cabin do recline plenty, so no need to worry about that. You are near the galley, but I didn't notice any noise, aside from that electronic whirring noise that all A380 galleys seem to make throughout the flight. If anyone knows what causes that noise, I'd be curious to hear. This is lovely lighting for an evening flight, the perfect color if you ask me, plus it kind of evokes a desert sunset. You get a very comfy pillow and a little blanket. Not too long after takeoff, a dinner service begins, including a full bar for drinks. The cabin crew are top-notch on this one, providing a very friendly and thorough service, even in economy. Yes, Etihad knows who I am on this flight, so you might expect the cabin crew to be extra nice. But I saw how they interacted with other passengers, and I wouldn't say I got any special treatment here that everybody else didn't get. And just so you know, Flight Radar 24 paid full price for this ticket. I end up having the vegetable biryani, and this one may look a little basic, but it tastes great. Now, one piece of special treatment I did get was being invited up to the upper deck lounge and bar area. If you're traveling with friends and can find a few seats free, this is a great space to go hang out in and break up the journey, provided you're flying business or first class. There aren't many seats though, so you may have to hover for a while to grab one. I then took another quick look at the first class apartment and tried out sitting in the seat. Yes, I definitely need to try this out on an actual flight soon. I missed the ice cream service back in economy, so I grabbed one in the galley along with some other snacks. And this flight is actually pretty short. It's already time to descend into Abu Dhabi.
Your reading light switch is in your seat area, thank you. Welcome to Abu Dhabi.
أسعد الله صباحكم بكل خير أهلا بكم في أبو دابي حيث شير توقيت محلي للساعة 1:15 من أجل سلامتكم نرجو منكم البقاء جالسين في مقاعدكم وإبقاء أحزمة المقاعد مربوطة بإحكام إلى أن توقف الطائرة توقفا كليا ويتم إطفاء علامات أحزمة المقاعد.
This flight was just prior to the full opening of the new terminal. I'm really eager to get back there and see it for myself soon.
It has been our pleasure having you on board, and we do look forward to being of service to you again sometime in the very near future.
about requesting.
All right, what a nice flight with Etihad on the A380. In economy this time, there's crying kids everywhere. It's late at night. It's 1:30 in the morning. We're now in Abu Dhabi. Nice to be back, and what a great flight with Etihad on the A380 in economy. Mostly because of the lovely cabin crew, they were just great. But also that amazing wing view and that extra space seat. If I have to fly economy, I think that's the one I want to do it in. A little bit of extra legroom, nice spacious cabin, quiet A380, that wing view, and of course the Etihad service, which is just a step above, especially when you're used to European carriers, American carriers, most of them really. Gonna have about 20 hours to rest now in Abu Dhabi, maybe get some pool time in the sun, big contrast to back home in Sweden, prepping for the big one tomorrow, Abu Dhabi to Osaka on the Dreamliner in the flight deck. That should be really cool. Anyway, thanks for coming along on this one, and we'll catch you next time. In Abu Dhabi for Flight Radar 24, I'm Gabriel Leigh.